Good morning, guys. Woke up in Rome today. It's our second day in Italy. We just got in last night, hella tired, crashed. But today I'm really, really excited to see one of the things that I've always wanted to see my entire life, which is the Vatican City and also the Colosseum. And we're gonna go on a walking tour for both. So we're gonna go inside both of them and that's gonna be fucking awesome. But the only downside is I heard that they have really strict camera restrictions. So I'm gonna try to record as much as I can. Obviously for you and for me, for my own personal memories, but I am super excited. But before we get into that, this hotel room is the creepiest fucking hotel room that I've ever been in. I'd actually had a hard time sleeping last night because when I'm just laying in bed with all the lights off, there's this weird thing, right? This looks kind of modern right now, but at night it starts glowing and looks like this giant eyeball that's just staring at me. Did you have a hard time sleeping, Mom Bear?
I was so jet lagged, or I still am so jet lagged. You were talking about people playing music and being all loud and stuff yesterday. I did not hear a damn thing. So when I first walked in, I initially was like, this is fucking creepy.
Yeah.
Some murders were caught, like happened in this room, and there's definitely a ghost here. But last night, I was like, I don't care. I'm going to sleep. So I knocked out, sorry.
You didn't hear all the weird noises? Like the fans?
Don't say that.
Like there's constant fans going on, and there's constant like noise like this, like in the middle of the night.
Wait, you better not be lying to me.
I would hear this in the middle of the night.
Those are rats.
Oh, really?
You promise you hear that?
I heard it.
Stop, don't tell me this stuff
no,
right
no,
now.
No, I'm serious. I would
don't tell me this stuff because we gotta still sleep here.
Only one more night, but I would hear like this. I'm like, oh shit.
You swear you were scared.
And then afterwards I would hear people say, pizzeria, mamma mia.
You're dumb. Are they delivering pizza?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, maybe they're just knocking on doors like, this is all the pizza, pepperoni.
You jerk, you scared me.
No, but I did hear noises though. But I have to give props. I have to give props to the person that designed this room because even though it's fucking scary as shit, like, hold on, let me show you the level of scariness I'm talking about. I don't think you guys know. You know you're in a scary ass fucking place when you got shower knobs like that.
True.
When you got gangster old school shower knobs that haven't been polished, people always use knobs like this for murder scenes. Look at this. And the toilet doesn't even flush. Ew, what is that?
That See? Was you.
Fine. So this is a scary ass place, but I gotta give them props because they got mad Italian pride. This room is straight Italian colors. Look at it. Green, white, red. I'm sleeping in an Italian flag.
You are.
Look at these fucking curtains. Mom, did you see these curtains? Look how creepy they are. It's flowers.
You already creep me out so much.
No, look at these fucking curtains. These are haunted curtains from...
I can't.
Oh,
I'm
my
not
God. This is fucking freaky. Look at these fucking freaky ass flower curtains. Fuck, it's fucking scary. And then you see this chair? Look at the pattern on this chair. That's fucking death pattern. Oh my God. You know there are ghosts and souls in here. This is the freakiest hotel room I've been in so far, Ma Bear.
Oh no. The one in St. Berg or...
St. Berg? Where's St. Berg at?
Gorge?
Where's that?
Germany?
Oh, St. Goar?
Oh, Goar. Yeah. God, I'm horrible.
St. Gorge.
That one was pretty creeps, for sure.
I think this one's way creepier.
I don't know why you keep emphasizing, you know I'm scared. It's gonna be cut camera, and then the freaking sun's gonna set, and I have to sleep here. I'm gonna think of all this shit you just said. You're the worst.
That I'm just explaining what freaked me out.
No, put it outside. Stay away from me. I still gotta sleep here.
All right, fine, sorry. Well, on another note, I'm very, very excited to see two of the things that have been on my bucket list for millions of years, even though I haven't been on this earth for that long. But I'm really excited to go see them. Inside the St. Peter's Basilica inside the Vatican City, and I think hands down this is the most magnificent interior of almost any ancient building that I have ever been in. It's just so breathtaking. I'm actually surprised that we're able to talk and stuff like this because me and Ma Bear, we've been in a lot of other like holy buildings, and you usually have to be quiet. You can't take pictures or anything like that. So it's really cool that I am able to. But I've seen this part in a lot of movies. I think Angels and Demons, and it's just amazing to be in a place where popes have been for centuries, and it's right behind me. It's crazy. Like if I was allowed, I would want to just do 20 cartwheels and 50 backflips and start screaming, "Wow, the bears are here!" But I can't because I'll get arrested and probably shot.
And this is in St. This is a what?
St. Peter's Basilica.
Okay, so this is the St. Peter's
Basilica.
Basilica with a B. My mind registers that as a B. And we are currently on. What are we? Where are we right now?
We are on land.
No. What is this place called? Oh, we are in the
Vatican City.
The Vatican City.
Yes.
I don't know. My mind right now is all forms of jacked up. We are in the Vatican City.
Are you having a holy experience, maybe?
Maybe. So I don't really know too much of this. I don't know too much of this area. This is what's crazy too, and this is gonna be really funny. I was raised Catholic.
How do I know more stuff than you if you're raised Catholic?
Because you were cheating. So he cheated, and he knows more right now because while he was pooping, he was looking stuff up. So that's not fair.
On Wikipedia.
So the only thing I know that happens here is the Pope.
That's it?
The Pope visits
that's
here.
That's a noun. It's not even a verb.
Pope. So
that's like saying the only thing I know that happens here, parrots.
So the Pope is here, and then they elect their next popery.
Popery, the papacy. Popery's bad impression.
I'm kidding. I swear. I don't mean to offend anyone. I'm Catholic. I'm only kidding. But no, I know that they lock them up here, and that's the way our tour guide. That's the way our tour guide described it. Hold on, because back in the day, they would go to different cities, and then they would take their time to vote who they want to make the next pope. And then what ended up happening was, they would take 1-2 years, kind of taking advantage of that little town. Not to say that they did anything bad, but they were like, wait a minute, this process is taking way too long. So they gathered everyone that elects, you know, the next pope, and then they were saying, okay, well, where do you guys want to hold this meeting? And then they said,
the next pope.
And then they said, what? To elect the next pope. And then they were like, all right, well, we picked the Sistine Chapel, which is in the Vatican City. So that's the extent of what I know. And I think they vote for, I think, maybe 6 days, 7 days off, obviously, because they have to go to church.
This isn't the Sistine Chapel, though.
No, this isn't it, but it's... No, I said it's on the premise.
Yeah.
No, I said that.
Okay. This is St. Peter's.
I'm trying to show that I'm smart. No, I know that. I know that, but I'm just saying we're standing in the Vatican City.
Yeah, but you also brought a Sistine Chapel. I don't know why.
Because isn't it here?
Well, it's not here. It's like all the way over there.
Right, but is it still in the Vatican City?
Yes.
Because I don't really know anything. Okay, but hold on. I'm trying to show them that I know what I'm talking about. So then they said, well, we
just
want
so
to
you know,
have
we're
our meeting.
We're allowed to make out because we're married. And in the eyes of the Catholic
but
Church.
They don't know that because we don't have rings, so they're not going to honor it.
No. God knows everything.
Hey, so then what happens is they said, hey, well, we want to meet in the Sistine Chapel. We'll be locked up there, and then we'll choose. And then once they choose, then they go outside of one of these buildings.
they go outside of this one now.
Yeah, they go outside. Oh, is this this one? Okay,
yeah, so
they
the
go
one,
outside
the
of this
pope
one,
that's newly
and
elected,
then the Pope
they
comes
go
out.
Outside, which we'll show you later. They go on top of this balcony, and then to express to the whole world, this is the new mofo that you listen to.
Yeah.
I was going about to say the other word, but we're in a holy place,
yeah, you
so
can't
I,
do that. You
I can't
do
be
that.
Cussing.
But we can still make out because we're married.
Yeah. Ma Bear?
Yes, Ma Bear?
Oh my God, you have to look at this. Not the curtains behind me. Those are just curtains. But
they are very nice.
But if we walk this way, so what is amazing is behind you. I'm not going to turn the camera around yet. But as
I've
we
seen
walk,
your channel before, by the way.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
So that's also not what's amazing.
Well,
that's just
that
a fan.
Kind of is amazing.
That is,
thank you.
Thank you. God, did you see that? I'm kind of cool too, okay? So as we're walking here, it's already magnificent and huge what we're looking at directly in front of us, which is the main altar. But as we walk by each one of these arches and pillars, it's even more breathtaking. So you don't, when you walk in, you don't really see everything. you kind of just see like that main altar in the
which
beginning.
Which is gorgeous.
But then as you walk by, there's these arches that kind of have its own like sub magnificence.
There's someone walking up there.
Where? Look, what? Look. Wow.
Is he taking
laps? Holy moly.
That's crazy. I didn't even know you could. There's one even higher than that.
Where?
So you see where the guy's walking? There's another level.
Yeah, there's one right there and there's one right there.
What in the world? I'm sorry, I didn't mean to cut you off, but when do you see a person?
But what I wanted to show is that. You see that gleam of light coming in?
That is gorgeous. But
can you imagine? So like back in the day when they made this place, probably like 1500s or 1400s, I don't know specific dates.
You sound smarter than me.
But back in those days, can you imagine the holy experience that you feel? Because nowadays, like
see why everyone was so devout.
Yeah, because like nowadays we learn about like basic science, you know, in elementary school.
Yeah.
But back in the day when you walk by and you just see this and you're walking in a holy building,
it's like God's real.
It's like God is here.
Yeah, God is real. But the other side of my brain goes, but what happens when the sun sets? There's no electricity in here.
It's probably even more gorgeous.
Where's the light source?
Then they light all the candles and stuff.
Oh, well, I hope.
Holy moly, there's a guy right behind you. What is he doing?
He's saying, go look over there.
I think he's going, west side.
Ooh, it's so beautiful. It's so realistic. He's just taking laps up there.
Who, that guy?
Yeah.
That's amazing.
I can't believe. Would you be afraid to be that high up? Because I know you're afraid of heights.
I am deathly afraid of heights, yeah, but cool. I'd be down to go up there just because it's a once in a lifetime thing. What? I'm down to do a lot
of
things.
Could you peek over and be like,
yes.
Fine. Can we get closer? I want to see.
Let's go.
I want to see everything.
So directly behind me, if you know your Bible studies, is the tomb of Saint Peter, and he is commonly regarded as the first pope, and he's buried underneath here, which is magnificent. So I was brought up Buddhist, but I can really appreciate Christianity, Catholicism, because it's so embedded into the modern Western world. So when I see stuff like this, it's like almost like reading about fairy tales and it coming true. And I'm just like, what? Peter's down there? What the heck? It's so beautiful. And like back in the days, like in Italian architecture and art, they always used 24 karat. That's where Bruno Mars got his song
now.
From. 24 karat magic in the ground. Oh. St. Peter's down there.
So disrespectful.
What? No.
Anyway, but yes, he's buried here. How beautiful is this?
Did you show him how tall this building is?
Okay, ready? Look at that. Look at that. I think he's getting on his tippy toes. You can ignore Bart. Holy moly. That is crazy. Oh my goodness. Where was the guy walking up there, right?
Yeah, but just to put it into perspective, where we are in relation to where you saw us, we're only halfway in the St. Peter's Basilica. There's still an entire half of where the altar is. This is just where Peter is buried.
God, this is so beautiful.
Mother.
Yes, Mother.
To your right, there's an actual service going on. There's someone down there. Probably a cardinal or someone. I don't know the Catholic terms. Chanting. Oh yeah, priest. And then right.
I knew that one.
And then right behind you is the main altar. Isn't that glorious? Oh my goodness.
Dang. Game of Thrones decoration has nothing on this place.
This place is amazing. You know what's crazy? I see this place, and in all its glory, and it makes me weak in the knees. Like when I first saw it, I was like. That's how it makes me feel. I'm like, oh, it feels so crazy.
Yeah, you feel super insignificant.
Yeah, it's such a. I don't even. Oh my goodness.
I can't even get past the idea that. So right now I can fathom how this was constructed, right? Because I'm thinking, okay, they had a hot, like they had scaffolds, they had like machinery.
Caterpillar
company come in with those. But then I snap myself out of it. And I'm like, no. They just had humans Like, they didn't have any of the fancy technology.
They had people wearing, they didn't have hard hats. They were wearing leather sandals with freaking rope belts.
Like.
And rice sack t-shirts.
How did we decline as a human race from something so grand and beautiful to what we have now? Well, granted, we'll say that they had more time than we did. That's all. We didn't have as many distractions as we had back in the day.
Oh my goodness. Because, like, you would think in the modern day, with all the technology, that the holy buildings like churches and cathedrals would be even more magnificent, right? Because they're able to build Vegas hotels, and you could just hire those guys to build your church. But nothing is ever as near as... I don't even know the
word. Yeah, there's no word.
That's a freaking Lamula Papala.
Lamula Papalas is Hiroshima's, you know?
We're gonna have to kiss. St. Peter, all the way
to 2000.
Oh my goodness. That is amazing.
The first one was, what, 64?
I don't even know what that means. It's Latin. In some ways, the papacy was able to keep better records than the monarchy, because religious peeps were the only ones that knew how to write.
Yep, that is the truth.
So they had really, really good records.
Yeah, like the list of the popes that we just saw. Like, they kept record of, like, the first all the way to the current. Like, how? How do you do this, guys? The popes were giants. Who wears rings this big?
Damn, they had some sausage fingers.
Maybe it goes on their toes?
Toe rings?
Or maybe it doesn't need to go anywhere. We're just saying stupid stuff.
Where does it go? These are
huge. Hold
on,
let me see. Number three. It's in Italian. Perfect.
Awesome. So they're Italian
so
toe rings.
I'm going to leave here more ignorant. Now I think they were giants.
So we just walked out of the Sistine Chapel, and unfortunately, we're not allowed to record in there.
They're so rude. They go, shh, no pictures.
But it is amazing, and I think it. No pictures can do it justice.
Nope.
And the reason why, I know a lot of people say that, a lot of people, oh, no pictures can do it justice, and it's probably because they suck at taking pictures. But the reason why pictures really can't do it justice, the way that Michelangelo painted the ceiling, it almost looks like there's light that flash from the bottom going up. Yeah. So there's this lighting effect, and all the...
It looks 3D.
Yeah, like all the images on the ceiling.
It's perfect.
It looks like it's coming out at
you. Yeah, it does. And I had to, like, really stare at it, because if you pan up real quick, all of these designs, they come off the wall, right? So there is that three-dimensional element to it, but on the Sistine Channel? On the Sistine
On Channel 16?
No, on the Sistine Chapel, there is nothing that's popping out at you, and it's all done... just pure shading and light manipulation.
Yeah.
Magnifique.
And which is why, like, all cameras, they kind of flatten out the images. So it looks a lot flatter than it is. But actually this stuff, that's a painting too. All the white things,
those are all
paintings. So
it's
like
not a Michelangelo original though.
So you can just imagine if this by some buster already looks good, you could only imagine the famous Michelangelo hooking it up. You got skills.
Yeah, y'all need to come out here.
So we are walking through one of the many, many hallways of the Vatican City. And there are just endless amounts of hallways. And it's huge. Wow, the Pope's used to powerlift? What is that? Whoa. Is that an ancient Catholic barbell?
Yeah, la ultima presa a la balanzaria barbell.
Wow, no wonder their fingers were so huge, putting two and two together.
Oh, yeah. So we're walking through all the hallways. And what's crazy, if you look down this hallway, you see a bunch of other archways, right? But it looks like it's a mirror effect. Like, it doesn't look like it's real. Like, you're really walking through it. It just looks like it's a mirror reflecting off of another mirror into another mirror.
There are endless amounts of hallways. This place is a palace.
It is a palace. It is. This is gorgeous. I wouldn't be surprised if there's like thousands and thousands of these things.
Mabe?
Yes, Mabe?
Can you believe that we're just walking next to a bunch of holy relics?
No.
Like, these are rings of past popes, cups of past
this
popes.
Is not empty.
Oh, those are all empty? Okay, here we go.
Here we go.
But like, look at this, look. Sculptures, metal objects, jewelry, tablets. That's the old school iPad, babe. Look at that. That's the OG iPad.
That is, right here, and that's the iPad mini.
Yeah, all of these things were items and relics from back in the day. Oh my goodness, this is amazing.
I just want to know why they got lost. I thought this place was like, nothing ever happened to it.
What do you mean? Oh, well, it's
I know they were trying to get attacked by the barbarians. And they built up these like crazy walls so that they could stay protected inside here. So I'm like, wait, where did those things come from?
So what happened was the Pope, the papacy didn't always have the Vatican City.
Yep.
And they used to actually go to war with a lot of people, even Italy itself. Italy, the kingdom.
Papacy?
Yeah, the Italy, the Italian kingdom.
Yeah.
It's kind of noisy in here. I'll continue outside. See you guys outside. Okay, this sounds better. We are now in the garden, and it's in the middle of the Vatican's. I don't know if it's in the middle, actually.
But don't even look at me for answers.
Okay. It's one of the many gardens in the Vatican City.
How many?
I think someone said 16. But I don't know if that was a tour guide or if a mom was like, how many ice creams do you want me to get? And the kid was like, 16.
And just to let you know, we just started this tour and with the tour guide, and I don't understand a damn thing.
The microphones were messed up. So,
and so was her English.
So her English was really bad and the microphones were messed up.
So I know nothing.
But the tour is over. So I got bits and pieces of information about the beautiful Vatican City, but please double check the facts if you want to learn more. All we can do is just share our beautiful experience and the fun that we had with you guys. And we log these memories. So all I know is this is one of the many gardens that are of the Vatican City, and there's supposed to be 16 of them. But back to what we were talking about earlier about all the relics being rediscovered.
Yep.
So those relics.
You were telling me that the Pope. Or the popery. Wait.
That's the bathroom freshener. The papacy.
The papacy. You're telling me that the papacy would go into war all the time.
Yeah, so the papacy. So back in the day, you guys know about the Crusaders, where the Crusaders fought for the papacy. So, or they fought for Christianity, but it's usually the Pope calling the shots. And so they would go into wars all the time. And so that's how they would lose like different relics and objects.
Oh, that makes sense.
And so when you're on the winning part of the war, that's how you're able to get your stuff back. And then I think it was barely until 1920 something where Mussolini granted the papacy the Vatican City finally.
What? So we're you read a lot while you were pooping.
I did.
That was a
so
long poop.
So the papacy used to be in the Vatican City, and they would expand their power into the Italian government. And of course, you know, there's always that a battle between church and state. So the Italian government's like, no, that's part of Italy, and the papacy's like, no, it's part of our religious control. So it'd go out and in and out and in and then move different places.
Like a pulsating butthole.
Exactly. And then finally, Mussolini was like, all right, we're gonna put in the Vatican City, and once and for all, boom, that's it. And they've been living here since then. And I think there are about 600 inhabitants in here, and they're pretty much all
this whole place. That's it.
And then they're all religious people, clergymen. There's only like one nun, a bunch of cardinals, and a bunch of Swiss guards. So that's the Swiss guard is a Switzerland government mercenary group that is designated to be bodyguards for the papacy and all the religious people in here.
Damn, yay for poops.
Yeah, yay for poops. But this is one of the gardens, and it's incredibly beautiful. And there are beautiful structures and sculptures from all over the world, from Egypt, from Asia, from ancient Rome. There's all kinds of stuff. So this is pretty much it. On to the Colosseum.
Oh, yeah.
All right, just kidding. One last thing that we have to document before we go to the Colosseum is St. Peter's Square. So we were all the way on the inside and we walked around the Vatican City, but this is one last magnificent structure that we have to see. And I think this is where they had the angel and demon scene. And it is humongous.
But it's gorgeous.
It is. Look at this. So from here, there's Roman columns that go all the way around, all the way until you have, boom, the St. Peter's Basilica. That thing.
Do you see that little window right in front of us though?
Yeah.
So there's windows up on the top row, but then there's only one that has like a rectangle.
Like a little balcony?
With some sort of like picture on it.
Yeah.
You see that?
Yeah.
That's when the Pope is chosen and has been chosen. That's where they come out and they greet, and there's thousands and thousands and thousands of that fill up this whole plaza, this whole square.
Yeah.
And then they're like, "Rah!" and they cheer for him.
Yeah, popes are literally like rock stars.
They literally are.
Because even what we were talking about before, where the popes, back in the day, they used to go from city to city to have the election, and the different churches that would accept them, they were like so happy. They're like, "Oh, hell yeah, you have a meet and greet here?
Yeah.
And then finally, like what you're saying, they finally like, "Okay, cool, you guys are traveling way too much. Let's just lock them all up."
And it's taking way too long.
It's taking way too long to choose a pope, because sometimes it takes a couple years, like you're saying.
Yep.
Boom, it's done here in the Sistine Chapel. But the St. Peter's Square, it is...
No joke.
Stand here and just stare at it.
Look at the nativity display.
The what display?
Nativity.
What is that?
It's like how like Jesus was born in like a barnyard and all that stuff.
Wow. You do know some stuff.
I don't even know if I described that correctly, but I just know that it's empty, like the little bassinet that it's in. It's empty up until Christ is born. And then they put the baby Jesus in there, and it's like, yay, he's born. And then a few weeks later, then that's when the three kings come, and then they give their gifts and stuff. But for the Mexicans, we just leave a shoe out, and then we put little treats and little stocking stuffers in the shoe.
You know what?
What?
You just redeemed yourself. And because of that, you get a kiss.
Yes.
Cantare, oh, nel blu dipinto di blu, felice di stare lassù, e volavo, volavo felice, più in alto del sole ed ancora più su, mentre il mondo pian piano spariva lontano laggiù. Una musica dolce suonava soltanto per me. Volare, oh, cantare, oh,
I can't believe this, but I have to believe it because I'm on it, so there's physical proof.
It's real.
The Colosseum, the Roman Colosseum in Rome, and that's where Roman Colosseums are.
That makes sense.
But it's in the Colosseum.
In the Rome.
In the Italy. And I can't believe that we're actually in a place where history happens. Well, obviously history happens in places.
Yeah.
But I just can't believe that we're in a place that has so many thousands of years of history.
Yeah.
Thousands of people have been here.
I learned this stuff back in high school.
I learned this stuff in a movie called Gladiator.
I learned some stuff there too.
What did you learn?
I learned that Russell Crowe lost his wife and then was a prisoner of war and then was forced to fight for his life.
Is that a real story? Or is that...
No, I said Russell Crowe.
Oh, okay, fine. So yeah, so that's an awesome thing that you learned. But we also learned a bunch of stuff. In today's walking tour, and one of them that was major is that every single modern arena was modeled after this place.
It was, and you know where the arena comes from?
Where?
So, at the foreground where the gladiators and the animals and stuff would fight,
yeah,
they would put wood, and then underneath the wood, they would put a layer of sand. And
9 inches of sand, too.
9 inches of sand. Underneath the sand is where all the animals and the fighters and the gladiators and prisoners would stay before they would start fighting, right?
Yeah.
So then, every single day, so many deaths would happen that blood would absorb, the sand would absorb the blood.
Yeah.
And that's where they get the sand from, because in Latin it means, it is arena.
Yes.
And then that's where you get arena.
Yeah. So it's from the sand.
Yep.
It's kind of like they use like the building blocks of like a building, like a brick. And they use that building block to call out the entire building. We're just walking around in circles right now because we want to show you. Because we want to show you everything. And there are a ton of places. Let me just sit down for now. Let's just sit down right here real quick. So yeah, this place is so beautiful. All the modern day arenas are built from, are modeled after this place. And what did they used to, they also said that this place fills 50,000 people.
And you know.
And they can empty 50,000 people in 15 minutes because they have 80 archways at the bottom. And they're all numbered, just like a modern stadium. You know when you go to a modern stadium, there's numbers and there's gates and stuff.
Yeah, they got it literally from that. What they would do, they would get pieces of broken clay.
Yeah.
And in that clay would give you a number, right? And that number was associated to the particular archway because there's 80 of them, like you mentioned.
Yeah.
And then, so they would know what archway to walk in. They had a row number and a seat number.
I can't believe they thought of this thousands of years ago already.
Yeah.
That's so fucking crazy. Yeah. Wait, can I cuss here? Oh, no, this place isn't holy.
Yeah.
Sorry if it is holy to people.
Yeah.
So that's so crazy. There's so many things that we learned about this. And I think during this period of time where they had 100 games, the 100-day games, they were saying they killed 1,000 people. So they had one death every 5 minutes, and they killed 9,000 animals.
Isn't that crazy?
It's fucking sad, but it's also fucking crazy
cool.
They
were just like, you know what? Why don't we put a dog against a porcupine? Just because we can, and we're curious to see what happens.
Yeah, so I highly recommend coming here too. And the below, we also were shown like the inner workings of, or the underworkings of the Colosseum. And they had how many elevators? Like 50 or something?
60.
60 elevators. So people operating chains is like this entire.
It looked like you were jacking the air off.
No, it was chains.
Okay.
And so they had like this entire underworking labor force that they didn't really know
like
about.
Like 500 people would work down there.
Yeah, because it was completely covered. So I am still in awe. I heard all these stories and I can't believe I'm leaning up against this fucking brick.
That is amazing.
This is amazing. Is this everything that you thought of and more?
No, it's more than what I thought of because I didn't realize. So it even took, I think it took like 8 years to build this thing. 8 freaking years. And I'm just
that's
like,
fucking crazy that it was only 8 years.
Only 8 years. Yeah, so
because they didn't have those giant building machines.
Yeah.
So to build something this humongous, like if you can fit 50,000, that's a modern day stadium. Modern day stadiums are like 50,000.
Yeah.
So if you can build, if they built something that to house modern day population in 8 years, I don't even know if our stadiums are 8 years. How long does it take?
Well, I don't know. That's a whole different story just because there's permits, there's a whole bunch of other stuff. So I wouldn't even compare it, but at that time, with the technology that they had, they were super, sorry, I'm burping. They were super efficient, and they just got it done. It was amazing.
Yeah. I'm still in awe. I'm just walking around, taking in this entire place, looking at all the arches and listening to all the history. It's very, very beautiful. Oh, one final thing.
All right.
So when you look at the building, you just see a bunch of holes. And people think it's because of the World War II, and there's like it's like from shrapnel or fragment, but it's not. It's actually this entire place was covered in marble before, but then afterwards, people they stole the marble, they broke it off, and that's why it looks all kind of like dull and holy.
Yeah.
Not holy as in like religious, but holy as in holes.
Yeah.
And so all the marble's gone. But can you imagine like if the sun were to hit this place and this entire thing was in white marble, it'd be gleaming.
Yeah, beautiful. I guess one final thing is. The fact that you've been talking so seriously, I can see from the corner of my eye, everyone's just like behind us doing a whole bunch of funny shit.
What are they doing?
I don't know, but they were doing like faces, or they were just, they just wanted some YouTube time. So,
I guess they get,
sorry
you
if
get,
that was distracting.
Well, you get the YouTube time.
Yeah.
Yes.
So Bart thinks.
Why are you putting the blame on me if it's wrong?
I can't confirm this, and it just sounds a little bit outlandish for me. But you could be right. I don't know.
Okay.
But he thinks these are bleachers.
It only makes sense because the arena is there, and over here we have all these steps.
I don't know, but I feel. Where does the second person go? Like this?
Yeah, just like that. I mean, you gotta keep in mind these are ancient structures.
Well, let's just say that they are bleachers. Then. Look at how tiny these people were. Like, they must have been really, really petite, because I feel massive right now.
You know, back in the day, you'd be considered a giant.
Probably. Because I think even the average height, I still feel like a giant.
The average height was like 5'3 back then.
Oh, shit.
Yeah. So even if you're, I think 5'6 was the old 6 feet.
Yeah. Well, They were tiny. I'm huge. I'm still huge. Not sure that these are steps, so we'll have to Google it later.
It kind of sucks that they even have to have a sign like this.
Aww. Up.
There's no climbing and riding on the wall. So there are. It already sucks when people are putting graffiti on public transportation, on public buildings. But this is history, guys. I don't even think this should have been necessary. I think all of us, just in our humanity, we should be able to respect those that have been here already. And we cannot duplicate this. So those of you guys out there that are still, you know, tagging, doing graffiti and marking up stuff, please just stop, especially on things that we can never reproduce again.
That's so sad. Come on, guys.
So if you look down there at every single one of those arches, just like a modern day stadium, they used to sell food and snacks down there. And also what's even crazy that kind of blew my mind was that they had the names of gladiators on beer cups. So that was when merchandising, the modern day jersey with the name, and you buy like Kobe's jersey for $200, modern day merchandising was also invented here. And that blew my mind. I couldn't believe that they had such a sophisticated sporting system, and the gladiators were ballers. They could buy their own freedom even after they were enslaved, because that's how much money they made. Isn't that crazy?